Hello and welcome to SP Architect. Today we'll continue the tutorial from the previous part. Let's jump to the tutorial. In the reference image, we have an opening here, as you can see. I'm going to do make the same. Click this edge, hit the minus. Overline that reference, and also here we have some extra openings. I don't know the exact location, but I'm going to make that something like this. So I just add the ones, and we are going to do this by using spread, and I'm going to add 4 additional copies. Let's look at A. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 4 is okay. Click OK and first click this corner to the second reference. There we go. We have some grass on this roof. To do that, I'm going to create another roof and subtract that one from the previous one, this one. In order to do that, let's just hit Shift and D, or you can just right click, move, drag a copy. Yeah, we have a copy now, and we are going to offset all edges by 30 centimeters. And I'm going to delete this triangle and make some chamfer by 200 centimeters and just offset like so how much you want. And I'm going to get rid of these openings and connect this one and this together and offset additional 30 centimeters. After doing that one, I'm going to change the override surfaces with some grass and change the thickness by maybe 10 cm. Right click, connect solid element operation. This is going to be operator and this is going to be target, subtraction and upward extrusion. Hit execute. There we go. Maybe we can change elevation higher. Yeah. And as for this roof material, I'm going to make that concrete. Maybe this one or a white one. So we have stucco white roof. Yeah, better. Also, all kind of walls. I'm going to make the same. Stucco white roof. Yeah. This is going to be the same with this one. I'm going to increase the thickness first. Duplicate, offset, inner 25 centimeters. 30 centimeters and click add as operator, click this as target, hit execute, change the material to the grass. And make this one white. White roof, click OK. And we can change the thickness. Maybe 20. Yeah. And I'm going to extend the top of the walls to the roof. and right click this wall, connect trim elements, click through and click the bottom part. And for this one, I'm going to reduce by manually. Yeah. Actually, we have a road here. Split from here. And as for the elevation, we are going to increase the elevation of this mesh. And after that, click the add as target, click the slab add as operator, hit execute. Yeah, there we go. And as for the final part, we are going to make the exterior size of this walls. We are going to make natural slope landscape. Click the mesh tool, click the polygonal, and click these corners. Maybe to here and this part, and to here and this corner. And this corner, and close the shape. Align this corner, change the thickness to the ground. And click this corner again. Here we have elevate mesh point. Yeah. And also for this corner. And also for this one. But this part is going to be different. We are going to change the top of the wall as sloped, similar to this angle. In order to do that, I'm going to prefer roof tool and click this rotated rectangular, and I'm going to decide which thickness we are going to have, maybe around here. And at first we are going to make our reference plane. Yeah. After that we are going to model our roof. Yeah. And you know this part. We just right click this, connect, trim, click the roof and click the bottom part. There we go. But since we have used these trim elements to roof shell, here you can see our problem. In this situation, in order to avoid this problem, we are just going to cancel this trim options and we are going to use solid element operation. I click this wall, click this add as target and add as. Yeah, target, and for this one add as operator with execute. And this is the way I prefer. Let's make the same for here. But I'm going to align this roof to do this wall and fix the inset dimension. Yeah, there we go. And we click this move node. We hover over this edge and hit the shift, and you will see that it will be locked to the edge. Yeah, there we go. And let's extend more. Yeah, let's make this 5. And all click this roof. And let's just make the same. First, we are going to determine our reference plane. After that, the second one is modeling the roof. And click the roof, add as operator, click the wall, add as target, execute. Maybe we can change this slope to this corner. Yeah. And extend also this one. Okay. Let's make the same for this part. We have something like that. maybe smaller or bigger, I don't know. And close the shape. And I'm going to change their elevation. Yeah, we did it wrong here. Let's go to floor plan. And I'm going to give that some additional interior offset. Let's click the mesh and click the interior side. This will add some new points here. Let's click OK, go to F3 and elevate mesh points. For this one, it's going to start from ground. Elevate this mesh point. Maybe higher. Move node. Yeah. Okay. To make it smoother, let's just hit Ctrl plus D and click this all ridges smooth. Click OK. Now we have organic landscape here. To make it smoother, we are going to extend this side edges, side points. Maybe to the side of the roads. Now we have completed our roofs and our building, and this time I'm going to make here a triangle fountain and some plant openings for this part of the building. Let's go to floor plan and pick up any walls here and actually this one, this is a straight wall. Hover over this edge and you will see that it will be referenced. Hit the shift to locked, yeah, and intersect. And as for the thickness, let's click not linked and give that some 40 centimeters. Click OK. Maybe we can make this smaller to do this corner. And I'm going to make this 60, sorry, wall thickness 60. As for the height 50. And I'm going to duplicate and Ctrl plus D, offset this reference 15 centimeters and change the thickness maybe 5, 15, yeah, and as for the height, let's input here 10 or 5 and hit Ctrl plus D again and make this junction order to 7. After doing that, I'm going to change the ground of this pool. Let's alt click this slab or click from here and click the corners. After that, you just change the surface elements stucco by trough. It will be the same and click this at S operator. Click this as target, hit execute, and elevate to the ground. As you can see here, this side edges has appeared. To fix that, I'm going to increase this wall thickness to 63 and click this bottom point, stretch height to the white ground. And I'm going to change the intersection order, masonry block structural, to the maximum. Click OK. And here we have mesh and walls intersected. I'm also going to subtract it from this ground, pull ground. Click this add as operator and click the mesh as target and execute. And after that, I'm going to change this offset, maybe another 5, but let's try that again. Click this as operator, click this grass as target, click the upward extrusion, hit execute. And sometimes ARCHICAD do that. I'm going to fix this manually. Just click the mesh and click any corner or edge, hit the subtract from polygon and click the corners manually, but it works. Yeah, there we go. And I'm going to make a border. Just copy this slab and change the material to border wavy. Yeah. As for the final step, I'm going to make here an opening. Just click slab, hit the corner, hit the minus, and this rotated rectangular from this corner extend to this corner. And as for thickness, let's make this 100 centimeter. There we go. Actually, we can connect this together. Maybe. Click this corner and hit the add polygon. You just overline from that one. Okay. Also, I want to add some additional rod here. All click this slab and the same method, rectangular to the here, and maybe 600 centimeters. Crop the edges. Maybe we can extend this landscape. Let's look at what we have in 3D. To fix that, I'm going to change this, move this node first. After that, maybe we can, I just first click this rod, after that click the edge, hit the add polygon, hit the spacebar and click our second wall rod, and now we can get rid of this new rod, and as we can see they were added together. And I'm going to fix this. This is the end of this video tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you like this one, please hit the like button and leave your comments in the comment section below. Do not forget to subscribe, because in the next part I'm going to render this model in ARCHICAD. Also, I'm going to add this model to my Patreon page if you want to download. Alright, see you in the next one.